Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about full-wave bridge rectifier. In earlier video, we discussed about center-tapped full-wave rectifier circuit. It requires a center-tapped secondary winding transformer to divide AC input voltage into two equal and opposite voltages before converting AC into DC output. Now let's discuss second type of full wave rectifier, that is full wave bridge rectifier. The need for a center tap transformer is eliminated in bridge rectifier circuit. Full wave bridge rectifier consists four diodes. To design this circuit, just connect two diodes, let's say diode D1 and D2 in series, and another two diodes, let's say D3 and D4 also in series. Connect anode terminals of D1 and D4 and also connect cathode terminals of D2 and D3. Now connect a load resistor between anode junction and cathode junction of the diodes. We will apply AC input voltage at this diode's junction and we will get output DC voltage across this load resistor RL. Positive voltage at cathode junction of the diodes and negative voltage at anode junction of the diodes. Now let's discuss how this circuit works. If we apply AC input supply to this circuit, during positive off cycle, this end becomes positive and other end becomes negative. This makes diode D2 and D4 forward biased and conducts current, while other two diodes D1 and D3 are reverse biased and acts as an open circuit. Hence, we get output across load resistor RL through diodes D2 and D4. So, during positive off cycle, the current will flow through this path. If we assume these diodes are ideal diodes, the same input voltage appears across load resistor RL. During negative off cycle of input AC signal, the top end becomes negative and lower end becomes positive. This makes diodes D1 and D3 forward biased and conducts current, while other two diodes D2 and D4 reverse biased and acts as an open circuit. Hence, we get output across load resistor RL through diodes D1 and D3. So, during negative half cycle, the current will flow through this path and we get output voltage across load resistor. If we observe over here, during positive and negative half cycles, the current flowing through the load resistor RL in the same direction. Hence, we get the same output in both half cycles. If we combine the positive and negative half cycles output, we will get this kind of output waveform. In full wave rectification, DC output will appear for both off cycles of input AC voltage. Therefore, output frequency is doubled of its input frequency. Hence, the average value also doubled compared to off-wave rectifier. If we consider all diodes as ideal diodes, then average value is equal to 2 Vm by pi. That equals to 0.636 multiplied with peak voltage Vm. But in practical, two diodes have forward voltage drop for one off cycle input. Hence, maximum value Vm is reduced by 2 times threshold voltage Vt. That is Vm minus 2 Vt. So the average value can be expressed by 2 Vm minus 2 times threshold voltage, that is 2 Vt divided by pi. For example, 2 Vt equals to 1.4 volt for silicon diodes and 0.6 volts for germanium diodes. Recall center tapped full wave rectifier's average value. It is 2 Vm minus Vt divided by pi. Here only minus Vt. That is because of only one diode's forward voltage drop. So, we can say that full wave bridge rectifier's average value is lower than center tapped full wave rectifier. Now next parameter, peak inverse voltage of bridge rectifier. For example, during the positive off cycle of input AC voltage, diodes D2 and D4 conducting, while diodes D1 and D3 are reverse biased or off condition. In that case, current will flow through diodes D2 and D4 and output appears across load resistor RL. During this period, the reverse voltage across the diodes D1 and D3 are, let's say, VD1 and VD3 respectively. Just assume that all four diodes are ideal diodes with no forward voltage drop. In that case, diodes D2 and D4 just acts as a closed switches. So the reverse current VD1 and VD3 are equal to Vout. Here Vout is nothing but Vin. So we can write VD1 and VD2 are equal to Vin. And if the peak value of AC input voltage is Vm, then the peak inverse voltage across the diodes D1 and D3 are also equal to Vm. So the PIV rating of diodes must be greater than peak value Vm of input AC voltage. Recall center tapped full wave rectifier's PIV. It is 2 Vm. Hence, we can use less PIV rating diodes in full wave bridge rectifier circuit. If we observe the full wave bridge rectifier's output voltage, it is not pure DC voltage. It is pulsating DC voltage because there is some periodic variations in the output waveform. These variations are known as ripple voltage or AC variations in DC output. These ripples can be reduced by using filter circuit at rectifier's output. Just by connecting a filter circuit or a capacitor as a filter at the output, we can smooth out the ripples in the DC output. Now let's understand how this filter circuit works. Just assume that all diodes are ideal diodes with no forward voltage drop. Initially, this capacitor is uncharged. During positive off cycle, these two diodes D2 and D4 conduct, while D1 and D3 are off. So through diodes D2 and D4, the capacitor starts charging up to the input voltage reaches to its peak value. At this time, the charge across the capacitor Vc equals to Vm, and output across the load resistor is also Vm. After the input voltage reaches to its maximum, it begins to decrease. At this time, the voltage across the capacitor Vc is greater than input voltage. Because of this, the voltage at the cathode of the diode D2 and anode of the diode D4 exceeds their other terminals voltage. Due to this, D2 and D4 also gets reverse biased and becomes off. Now the charge across the capacitor will get discharged through load resistor RL. So our output waveform appears like this. The capacitor keeps on discharging during the negative off cycle of input signal until the capacitor charge Vc equals to input voltage Vin. When input negative off cycle peak arrives, the diodes D1 and D3 starts conducting and recharges the capacitor to the peak value Vm. And again, output voltage equals to peak voltage Vm. As soon as input voltage is less than Vm, diodes D1 and D3 becomes reverse biased due to voltage stored in capacitor is more than input voltage. So D1 and D3 switches off. So the charge in the capacitor will get discharged through load resistor RL. So output waveform appears like this. The capacitor keeps on discharging until the charge in the capacitor Vc equals to Vin. Like this, we can reduce the ripples in the output. Now, if we analyze the input and output waveforms, the slopes in the output shows discharging of the filter capacitor and the peak shows charging of the capacitor. So, in the circuit, how well the ripple is removed is depends on the RC time constant of the filter circuit. So for better rejection of these ripples, the RC time constant must be much larger than this time period T dash. If the RC time constant is less than the time period T dash, then the capacitor will discharge quickly, and this increases ripples in the output waveform. To avoid this, we should check RC time constant of the filter circuit. But still, if you notice, there is some ripples in the output waveform, and this voltage is known as peak-to-peak ripple. This peak-to-peak ripple can be given by expression Vm divided by 2f times RL times C, where f is the frequency of input signal. As we know, full-wave bridge rectifier output frequency double of its input frequency. So this 2f can be replaced by this frequency f dash. Suppose if we want to find the DC voltage of this waveform, then VDC can be given by the expression Vm minus peak-to-peak ripple divided by 2. That means here the DC voltage will be the subtraction of this Vm minus off of this peak-to-peak ripple voltage. That will be the approximate DC voltage of this waveform. So this will be the expression of DC voltage after the filtration. Suppose this ripple voltage is much less than peak amplitude of the sine wave. In that case, the approximate value of DC voltage will be equal to Vm. This ripple voltage can also be expressed in terms of load current. That is IDC divided by 2f times C. How well this ripple in the output can be removed is defined by the parameter, which is known as ripple factor. The smaller the ripple in the output, the more effective is the rectifier. Ripple factor can be defined as the ratio of RMS value of AC component to the DC component in the rectifier output. For full wave bridge rectifier without any filter circuit, ripple factor is equal to 0.48, while in off wave rectifier it is about 1.21. So ripple factor can be improved by using full wave bridge rectifier. It can be further increased by using filter circuit. For full wave bridge rectifier with filter circuit, the ripple factor can be given by this expression. Next parameter, efficiency. Efficiency defines how well AC input power is converted into DC output power. The efficiency of full wave bridge rectifier is 81.2%. Recall off wave rectifier's efficiency, that is 40.6%. Therefore, full wave bridge rectifier is twice effective than a off wave rectifier. Here I have summarized different parameters which we have discussed for full wave bridge rectifier. Some parameters we have discussed very briefly. We will derive all expressions in another video. This table showing comparison between off wave rectifier, center tapped full wave rectifier and full wave bridge rectifier's parameter values. Please go through this comparison chart. That's all about full wave bridge rectifier. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.